Very good morning, students. I, Asad Patel, welcome you to study from home. In my previous classes, I taught you about in the earlier city, especially Harappan civilization, right? I explained you the points, the story of Harappa, speciality, characteristics, houses and drain system, the city plan, life in a city, especially in life in a Harappa, as well as the new craft, raw material for the craft, okay? And the food for people in the city. So I taught you that Harappa consists of six main cities: Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, and other cities. Right, today I'm going to just give you a small revision. I'm going to explain about some points for that will help you to revise the chapter. The story of Harappa, I taught you about the buildings, okay, how their buildings made up of, okay. Now, what was special about that city? Now, you know, speciality that their drainage system, their road, their plan of houses, as well as they remain open space around their houses for, you know, cattle purpose or plantation, as well as I explain you that how old this is it, that okay, what was a special, you know, speciality. So speciality was a city plan. Now all these cities were situated near river or near bank of river. Why the cities are located or situated near river or around the river? Just because of to get the easy water access, or to get the to availability of, for the availability of water. That's why the city situated near the bank of river or river. The drainage system, right? The drainage system was very planned, so water won't get, you know, stuck, and they don't have problem of, you know, overflow of the drainage system, right? Their drainage were large as well as broad, so water and slowly, so water can get water could get easily flow, right? Life in a city those days and these days, busy, right? In a city, people in those days, people generally work of a craft and other things, and they were trained into a one task. They were trained to do one task only, right? They don't have a multitasking ability, or maybe they by choice they don't want to, you know, do a multiple work. Why? Just because of perfection. Okay, they might be very conscious about perfection, so they train into a one profession or a one task only. For example, if someone is doing craft, so only craft. Someone is training Vedic, only Vedic. Someone is, you know, scribing, so only scribing. Okay, someone is, for example, building houses, so only construction, right? So these were a speciality, okay. Now, new craft in a city, terracotta toys as well as terracotta symbols, they have maybe message, okay, they use a symbolic language. Somehow they use a symbolic language to convey message, okay, to each other, to exchange the message through the symbol. It is possibility, okay. It was a possibility because there are so many hypotheses. There are so many hypotheses about the Harappan cities, and hypotheses, for your information, need ground as well as research work, right? It requires investigation. It has so many angles to, okay, examine. So we cannot say that it might be or it must be this only, okay? It has a lots of angle, raw material. Raw material, as I told you, that they send their armies or they send their person to different places to get the material. So this point say that they had a good relationship with other countries, right? Food for people in the city. In this point, they use plow, okay, to till the soil or to, you know, to turning soil, right? Closer look, town in Gujarat, Lothal, near a Vadnagar, right? Lothal is a Harappan site, and Harappa is a too large city, okay, that is divided into more than two countries, Afghanistan, Pakistan and India. In those days, Afghanistan, Pakistan and India was not existed, but their diameter was very, you know, large. It was a very, you know, well extended and well developed cities in those days. Now, the mystery of end, as I told you, in this book, they have a problem of overgrazing or flood, or maybe I told you that they hit that city, was hit by pandemic or epidemic, okay, disease. So maybe they move, okay, or maybe they half of the population has been died, half of the population has been moved, or maybe they don't get the friendly environment to do business. So for that purpose, half of the population moves somewhere, half of the population move other places. So migration also caused the end, but migration, we can't say that migration caused, you know, the disappear, but maybe some disease or overgrazing, or maybe, you know, flood, okay. But some archaeologists found that there were less rainfall, okay, that place received less rainfall, so chances of flood maybe less, okay, but we can't say about nature, as you know, because climatical change is a part of, you know, nature. So maybe climate got changed and these people couldn't cooperate, or these people couldn't survive, or maybe they couldn't be comfortable with the change, because in a previous chapter we learn about ice age, sudden change in a climate, all the, you know, area which is covered by ice, and that is very, you know, the ice is not get melt after so many years. Even these days, those places are very, you know, cold, okay, those places have, you know, those places have been covered with the ice, right? So we can't say, as I told you, I'm not sure, maybe I told you or not, that in a places where ice age take place or ice age occur, archaeologists found a mammoth which is a species of elephant, and that mammoth was in a as it is condition. That mammoth, they rescued the mammoth in a condition, in the same condition before 10,000 years. Even that food in his mouth, in its mouth as well as in its stomach, were remained, okay? So we can't say that, okay? Climatic change, okay? So that was all about in the earliest cities, how cities constructed, then business, then farming, agriculture activity, then raw material, and then end of city, end of civilization. So there are so many possibilities behind the end, right? So this is all about this chapter. Thank you.